Hello, I am Alice Delfinet from Metro France. I'm going to comment the web training of this Copernicus Marine Asia training. We show Python codes to plot web height and direction from Copernicus data. This is the first exercise. Then we will see how to plot a web rose, which represents the sea state climatology of a specific place. In the first main part, so we are going to plot a web height field with vectors for the web direction. The Copernicus global web model runs every day at a resolution of 112 degrees. It is forced by the SEMWF winds and the surface currents from the global Copernicus physics model. We will see that this point can be important for a specific area. Now, I don't get too much into details for this model configuration. You will have more information in these links. The first part consists in downloading the data. We have chosen in this example the situation of two huge typhoons in East Asia in say August and September 2020. So we have to download the significant wave height and the wave direction, so VHM not on VMDR. You could do exactly the same exercise with other wave height field like wind wave or swell 1 or swell 2 with its associated direction. So how to download the products? So you need to have a Copernicus account. And then you need to install the Motu client library in Python. You can rewrite this command in this cell, or you can write just this part in your shell terminal. And then you download the data thanks to this command. So you need to change the credentials. Here your username, here, and you rewrite your password here. So this is not very heavy data. It can take something like 1 minute to download it. For me, it's already done. And you specify here in which directory to download data. For me, they are in this directory. And when it is over, you can verify it thanks to this cell here. And you see that I have two netcdf files in my data directory. So it's okay, we can begin. And then we are going to see what is the required configuration for Python. We are tested with version 3.7.10, and me, I have a version 3.7.3. But it is it works all the same. You have here the command to install the good Python version, and then you have to download some modules that are needed for the plot. They are listed here. You may know some of them, and you can install all of them with this line in your shell terminal. With exactly the good library version. I will now import the modules. This one and the others. I execute the cells. Here we have some interesting functions to check the directory, to get range indexes, to decompose the wind directions, We define a data path and the output path. So here we check the directories. We see which are the files, and you recognize the directories data and out directory. And here, this is imported data from Copernicus website. So the name of the file, we have downloaded it with Motu client. We open the netcdf. You can see what is the content of the netcdf. We have the coordinates, the data variables, significant write, web direction. You can ask specifically for the data variables with data vars and for the coordinates also. So I execute the cells. We are defining variables, and the name of the variables, and so we retrieve the data to plot in the variable, the main variable of the NetCDF. We retrieve significant divide, the wave direction, latitude, longitude, and time. We get the definition of the spatial window with the minimum, maximum of latitude and longitude. Here you can define the min and max value of a significant divide in the plot. We put it to none here. For this example, we decided to plot only one time step on two. That means we'll have a plot every 6 hours because the data is 3 hourly. Here we have the main code for plotting data. You have here some map configurations. For the axis labels here, the color bar, and then here there is a loop on for every time step. So you remember that we plot only a field every 6 hours here, and then there are the drawing commands below. So we run with cells. It can take some time. Yeah, we have already the first plot. It isn't easy to see the whole figure, so that's why we recommend to enable the scrolling. You can do that, or disable the scrolling. You can do that by a right click here and disable scrolling for output, and you can see more easily the results. So it begins the 99th of August 2020. You recognize East Asia, and this is a typhoon. It's the beginning of its life, and there is at this time only four meters of significant wave height, 4 or 5 meters. But it will strengthen. And it will begin a category 4 typhoon. Its name is Maysak, and it has been a deadly and powerful cyclone, and that struck Ryukyu Island and Korean Peninsula. Then, so the highest sustained winds that were measured are 175 km per hour. So some days after, you see that it strengthens, the wave height is stronger, and it comes near direct in direction of the north. And for instance, the 2 of September, it is the my sex cyclone is near Korea, and you have here another typhoon. It is a Haiten. It will also become a category 4 typhoon, very powerful. The highest sustained winds are around 195 km per hour. And here you recognize also a pattern here in the significant wavite. And it is you can see here the impact of the surface currents, because the wavite is depending, is forced by the surface currents, and we have here the strong currents of Kuroshio. And that is why you have these patterns here. So that is all for this exercise. But I imagine you can be deceived, because the color bar doesn't seem to be adapted to this powerful cyclone. You can imagine that there have been much more than 5 meters of wave height during this event. So you can play with the code and change some parameters. And for this topic, we can change the maximum of the color bar. So you come back and to this cell, min max value, and instead of none, you put 15, a very high value, and we run the drawing of the maps. So the color bar is now very different, with a very huge maximum of 15 meters. So it's quite blue at the beginning of the of this period. And yes, maximum is only 5 meters, yeah. But after some days, you can see here that the maximum is near 10 meters of wave height. It is 30 of August. When it reached the Ryukyu Island, the maximum is near 12 meters. And yes, when it reached Korean Peninsula, it was 15 meters. So it was very, very huge sea states. So you can play with other parameters to change the dates, the location of your extraction. You can choose a finer space window. This is a model at 1/12 resolution, so you can go much more near shore. So we go now to the second exercise. We are going to work this time with the wave reanalysis. Its resolution is 0.2 degrees. It is also forced by surface currents, and it is much more appropriate to climatological study. Because you have 27 years available. So you have more information on the Copernicus website. So we have chosen for this exercise a point in Southeast Asia and Southeast Malaysia in Indian Ocean. And we are going to download the products like in the first exercise. So we choose here a 10 years period. It is enough to have a climatological information, but it's better to use the whole period of 27 years. And so the download of the product is like In the first exercise, you need to have installed the Motu client library, and then you use this Motu client command with your own username and password. You choose to range to put the data in this out directory, and this with its name. So this time it is much more longer. You have to wait more than 10 minutes to have the data on your computer. So don't be afraid of this delay. Then you can verify that you have the file with this cell. And it is the same Python configuration with Python version 3.7.10 and the required modules. But you can remark there is one more WinRules here. So you may download it if you haven't it yet. Here with this command in your shell terminal. So when you have everything, you can execute the cells here to import the modules. We define some useful function, like before, we define the data path, out path. And we list the files. Okay. So the name of the netcdf file here. And we open the netcdf. In this variable WaveDS. What is there in these variables? So you have the coordinates, dimensions. We have chosen here a very little window, special window, because for WaveRules we need a very long time, but not we are going to work only in one point. The variables needed are significant wave height and wave direction. You could also imagine to work on a specific partition like wind wave or swell one to plot the wave rules of the wind wave and not of the total sea, for instance. But here we are working with the total sea. So if you want to have the variable names or the coordinates, you can use data vars or chords. You have already seen it. So we define the name of the coordinates and the variables. The point of interest, you could change it. It's in the middle of the spatial window of the domain. Where we extract this point and to have a specific selection. Here you can have you can see the latitude and longitude chosen. 6 degrees south and 102 degrees east. So we extract the wave height and then the wave direction. We define the bins, it's an important step. Depending on the region that you are installing of, you may change the definition of the bin. Here we have defined a maximum bin of more than 5 meters. So it can be less, it can be more, depending on the climatology. And we define a bin every 25 centimeters. For the direction, here we are respecting the bin of the model. The model has 24 bins, and that means each 15 degrees each. So this is a function for defining the function of WaveRules. And you have here this the crucial command, Python command. And we can plot it. So I already plot it. You will see it takes some time. Something like 1 minute to plot the wave rows. We recommend to play it with HSMax, as I said. Here we have decided to, in this example, to use 5 meters, and it is quite good, but it depends on the place. So here in Indian Ocean, in southwest Malaysia, you have every wave that are coming from south, and specifically, yes, the south sector. And the strongest waves comes from the south, with waves of more than 3 or 4 meters. They are exactly from south. So in this plot, you see that we represent the wave from the, that means the direction from which comes the waves, and not the direction to. So it's important to know that. And we show also possibility to plot a not normed wind wave rows. What is different? It's here with these numbers. Here it is in percentages. So the distance here to the center represents the percentage of occurrence of the wave height. For instance, here you have something like 20% of the time. 20% of the time, you have wave from the south, exactly the south, and 270 degrees, and of less than 2.5 meters. And here, in this distance, it represents maybe 15% of the time, you have a waves that are more than 2.5 meters and coming from the south. And the differences with the not normal rows is that you have not the percentage but the number of cases in your period of study. That here it is 10 years. Okay, you can have numerical information, very valuable. Here the number of the dimension. So 24 directions and 18 beams of occurrence of wave height, and you can get the percentage of occurrence of this matrix of these dimensions here. So you have here it is in percent. And you can also retrieve the data at every time step of these 10 years at this point. And you can record it, save it in a CSV file, like with these commands. So that's all for this last exercise. Don't hesitate to play with the commands to change the place or the period. And thank you for your attention.